as a first presenter. Anyway, our presenter's topic is Food of the Common People, Remarkable Japanese Trends. My name is Masae. These are my co-presenters, Maki and Saki.
Can you imagine your life where you use train every day? Unlike America, which has a big car culture, we have a remarkable train culture in Japan. Trains are important transportation in Japan, where many people live effectively on a small island.
First, I'd like to tell you about the history of Japanese trains.
Next, I will talk about the Japanese train commuter's life.
Finally, I will talk about the dark side of trains.
Let me begin with history. About 140 years have passed since the first train came to Japan. 140 years is very short compared with other Japanese culture. However, Japanese train is the most closely related to contemporary Japanese people's life. I have three topics. Today's Japanese trains, history of trains, and train tickets. Let's move on to my first topic, today's Japanese trains. Here is a map of Japan. The area inside of red circle is called Kansai area, where I live. In Kansai area, there are six prefectures, which is similar to a state in America. Let's look at the train route map in Kansai area. Each line is a station, and there are 1,662 stations in only Kansai area. Also, from this train route map, you can see all six prefectures are connected by trains. In Kansai area, we have three train companies. One of them is Japanese Railway, which is called JR. JR is the most famous train company in Japan. Also, we have Hanshin Train and Hankyu Train. These are only in Kansai area. So, Kansai area is connected by three train companies. Also, in Japan, we have two types of trains. One of them is electric train. Electric train is the most modern train in Japan. So, many Japanese people, including me, use electric trains to go to school or work every day. So, electric train is used for short distance. Also, we have Shinkansen. Shinkansen is a bullet train, and it can run 186 miles per hour, and it top class of speed in the world. So, Japanese people use Shinkansen for a long distance instead of airplane. Let's move on to my second topic, history of Japanese trains. In 1854, a model train came to Japan from America. The size of model train was one quarter of real train, but it surprised Japanese people. In 1870, Japanese government permitted the first construction of Japanese train, and there are three reasons for developing Japanese trains. The one reason is Japanese government wanted to connect all Japan with one train. The second reason is Japan has irregular landforms, and there are many forest areas, so it was difficult to build a road. Train needs a railway, but building a railway is easier than building a road. The third reason is train can carry many goods at one time, and it's faster than a car. So Japanese government needed a train to make New Japan at that time. In 1872, Japanese train started a business. The first train station is Shinbashi Station in Tokyo, and the first train was England locomotive train. This is because at that time, Japan didn't have any skill to make own locomotive train, so the first train was imported from England. 8 years later, in 1900, Japan started making own locomotive train, and train expanded all over Japan. In 50 years later, the first electric train started running, and the locomotive train was abolished. 10 years later, Shinkansen was constructed, since then, electric train and Shinkansen became main transportation in Japan. Let's move on to my third topic, train tickets. Here is a picture of the first train ticket. The first train ticket was imported from England with train. So we can see English on the first train ticket. Also, we can at the bottom of the ticket, we can see torn section. This is because tickets were punched by train staff before people got on the train for 100 years. However, in 1960, the number of train users rapidly increased and the station was overcrowded. So, in 1967, the first automatic gate was constructed at the Kitasenbi station in Osaka. Also, surprisingly, this is the first automatic gate in the world. The automatic gate can make sure the tickets are available or not and collect them automatically. So it can help to relieve the congestion. Because of the automatic gate appearance, the tickets were also changed. In 2003, the ticket of prepaid system began, and it especially called Ikoka in Kansai area. This is because Ikoka stands for IC operating card, but it is also play on a phrase. Ikoka sounds like Ikoka, which means let's go in Kansai dialect. Also, Ikoka has two functions. If you touch Ikoka on the automatic gate, you can use Ikoka as a commuter bus. Also, you can use Ikoka like a credit card to buy something in the station. In my conclusion, Japanese train has a short history but connects all of Japan. Japanese people's life become better and more convenient because of Japanese trains. Japanese train is necessary transportation in Japan. Thank you for listening. Next, Maki will tell you about train commuters' life.
Thank you, Saki. My name is Maki Furukawa. Now, I will talk about the Japanese train commuters' life. I have three topics: Japanese commuting, Japanese behavior, and punctuality of Japanese trains. Let's begin Japanese commuting. First, I will describe the necessity of Japanese train for commuting. The population of Tokyo is about 30 million people. Tokyo is a capital in Japan. However, when they include commuters from neighboring prefectures, there are over 30 million people in the Tokyo area. This is a ratio of people using their own cars or trains for commuting. Look at the green area. In Tokyo metropolitan area, only 9.8% use their own cars. In contrast, the purple area shows about 71.8% use the train system every day. Even national average, the purple area shows about a quarter of people use the train system for their commuting. By the way, it is usual to take 1 hour or more for commuting with trains for commuting in Japan. In my case, it totaled 2 hours from my house to university, and I spent over 1 hour on the train, including transferring trains 3 times. This is about 51.3 miles. Next, this is a picture of Shinjuku Station in Tokyo. During rush hour, trains are very frequent, although they are terribly crowded. Many people have to stand for a long time. Moreover, in Tokyo or some places, they have pusher packing passengers into train during rush hour. They wear white gloves and push gently. Let's move on to my second topic, Japanese behavior. Now, I will tell you what happens on Japanese trains. First, Japanese people are not demonstrative on the train. People keep themselves quiet and try to keep good atmosphere. Next, what do people usually do on Japanese trains? they find the way to protect their privacy, and they usually read books or focus on using their cell phones. Besides, it is not at all uncommon to see people as if they are the world, like this picture. Did you notice? These girls are me and first presenter, Saki. In fact, this picture was accidentally taken by third presenter, Masai. This is not on purpose for this presentation. This is our natural style. However, there are some reasons. They spend a lot of time on the train because they commute for long distance. And they work late, so often catch up sleep. Also, safe environment allows them to sleep. By the way, bags or wallets are rarely stolen from sleeping passengers. Let's move on to my third topic, the punctuality of Japanese trains. First, I would like to explain how amazing the Japanese punctuality is. For example, Tohoku Shinkansen, as Saki mentioned, which is a bullet train that runs about 120,000 times a year. Yet, an average delay time is only 36 seconds. Also, local trains, which is an electric train that runs every few minutes, yet an average delay time is less than 1 minute. In addition, in Japan, every platform of stations have stop positions. Trains always stop there correctly. Moreover, passengers line up for waiting them. It is very helpful that the train depart on time, because they can get on the train smoothly and fluently. Next, I will explain what happens if the train are late. There are some reasons, such as some accidents, signal problems, or weather. In Japan, even only 1 minute delay, people can know about it on the electric board. Moreover, words of apology, including reasons and place, are announced for passengers. Finally, I will introduce an interesting paper called Chien Douken. In Japan, if the train are late more than 5 or 10 minutes, the train company issues this paper. This is a delay certification on which is written how long the train was delayed, when, and where it happened. This paper is for passengers, especially businessmen or students. The purpose of this paper is to prove to their office or teachers of classes the reason for being tardy was unavoidable because of the delay of the train. In my conclusion, in Japan, majority people depend trains, especially for their commuting. And hundreds of people move together. Also, you can see some Japanese values, such as they are reserved and keep themselves quiet. And they expect it being punctual in their daily life. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Maki. My name is Masae. From now, I will talk about the dark side of trains. As Saki and Maki said, Japan is one of the countries where many people use the train. Now, Japanese train is necessary for our daily life. However, there are also problems among the Japanese train network. Of course, it is uncomfortable to talk about it, but I think it is important to know how these accidents made Japanese train develop. These are my three topics: train suicide, train accidents, and female-only train cars. Let's move on to my first topic, train suicides. Train suicides often happen in Japan, and it especially happens at the center of the city. Because of train suicide, 35,300 trains were delayed or cancelled in per year. So it means train suicides happens every day. If one train are delayed or cancelled, about 7,000 people were influenced. Because of train suicide, train company think about idea to prevent train suicide. For example, there are emergency stop button at the platform. If someone falls on the railway, other people push the button, and then alarm sounds at the platform and office. At the same time, the driver receives a warning, and then the driver can stop the train. Other example is platform barriers. When train came to arrive to platform, the barrier opened automatically. Let's move on to my second topic, train accidents. In this topic, I will talk about two accidents. One accident is derailment accident. 8 years ago, April 25th, derailment accident happened at Amagasaki, which is near my university. The driver drove the train too fast, and then train slipped at the sharp curve and crashed into the apartment building. So it happened in the morning, so there are many passengers who went work or school. Finally, this accident caused 668 casualties. After the accident, the train system was changed. At first, a number of trains was decreased. Before the accident, 8 trains ran every hour. But after the accident, train company decided 4 trains ran every hour. So it means 140 trains were decreased in a day. Also, train line color was changed. It changed blue to orange because train company consider people who lost family or friend at accident. So if people watch the blue line, people remind of the accident. That's why train company decided to change train line color. By the way, there are not only sad accidents. From now, I will talk about good story about Japanese train. It was an admirable accident around all over the world. In this summer, when a woman got on the train, she fell down between platform and train, so she couldn't get up by herself. Other people noticed her, and then they called train staff by pushing emergency button. And then train staff came to her. At first, they tried to pull her, but it was not going well. So finally, 44 passengers and 60 staff pushed the train, and then she was rescued. Surprisingly, she was not injured. After only 8 minutes, the train started to drive again. Let's move on my final topic, female-only train cars. There are many kinds of train in Japan. One of them is female-only train cars. It was introduced by many countries, but Japan is first country to introduce this train. In 1912, first female-only train cars was introduced because of woman discrimination. At that time, it was not good for woman to ride the same cars with men. However, it was disappeared soon. And then, now we have female-only train cars. But it was different reason. In 2000, This train was introduced again because of groping. And from this year, children, elderly people, and handicapped people can ride this train even if they are men. As you learned, female-only train cars has long history. It was reliable for women, but there are also problems. After this train was introduced, thousands of Japanese men were arrested because of groping in per year. But some cases were mistakes. So some people suggested men-only train, but it has not appeared now. In conclusion, there are many such accidents in Japanese train. These accidents connected with Japanese society. And also, Japanese people learn from accidents, and then they try to make an effort to solve these accidents. From these accidents, we can see Japanese wonderful character. Thank you for listening.
Let's review our presentation. The train which have developed in the short time the most is indispensable transportation in Japan. Many people depend on train for their daily life, especially their commuting. On the other hand, there are many sad accidents, but they all lead to the development of Japanese train in the future. From our presentation, we can say,
No train, no Japan!
Thank you for listening.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Discover Japan. Today is first presentation day, and we are the first presenters. Anyway, our presenter's topic is Hood of the Common People, Remarkable Japanese Trains. My name is Masae. These are my co-presenters, Maki and Saki.
Can you imagine your life where you use train every day? Unlike America, which has a big car culture, we have a remarkable train culture in Japan. Trains are important transportation in Japan, where many people live effectively on a small island.
First, I'd like to tell you about history of Japanese trains.
Next, I will talk about the Japanese train commuter's life.
Finally, I will talk about the dark side of trains.
Let me begin with history. About 140 years have passed since the first train came to Japan. 140 years is very short compared with other Japanese culture. However, Japanese train is the most closely related to contemporary Japanese people's life. I have three topics. Today's Japanese trains, history of trains, and train tickets. Let's move on to my first topic, today's Japanese trains. Here is a map of Japan. The area inside the red circle is called Kansai area, where I live. In Kansai area, there are six prefectures, which is similar to a state in America. Let's look at the train route map in Kansai area. Each line is a station, and there are 1,662 stations in only Kansai area. Also, from this train route map, you can see all six prefectures are connected by trains. In Kansai area, we have three train companies. One of them is Japanese Railway, which is called JR. JR is the most famous train company in Japan. Also, we have Hanshin Train and Hankyu Train. These are only in Kansai area. So, Kansai area is connected by three companies. Also, in Japan, we have two types of trains. One of them is electric train. Electric train is the most modern train in Japan. So many Japanese people, including me, use electric train to go to school or work every day. So electric train is used for short distance. Also, we have Shinkansen. Shinkansen is a bullet train and it can run 186 miles per hour and it's top class of speed in the world. So Japanese people use Shinkansen for a long distance instead of airplane. Let's move on to my second topic, history of Japanese trains. In 1854, a model train came to Japan from America. The size of model train was one quarter of real train, but it surprised Japanese people. In 1870, Japanese government permitted the first construction of Japanese train, and there are three reasons for developing Japanese trains. The one reason is Japanese government wanted to connect all Japan with one train. The second reason is Japan has irregular landforms and there are many forest areas, so it was difficult to build a road. Train needs a railway, but building a railway is easier than building a road. The third reason is train can carry many goods at one time and it's faster than a car. So Japanese government needed a train to make New Japan at that time. In 1872, Japanese train started a business. The first train station is Shinbashi Station in Tokyo, and the first train was England locomotive train. This is because at that time, Japan didn't have any skill to make own locomotive train, so the first train was imported from England. 8 years later, in 1900, Japan started making own locomotive train, and train expanded all over Japan. In 50 years later, the first electric train started running, and the locomotive train was abolished. 10 years later, Shinkansen was constructed, and since then, electric train and Shinkansen became main transportation in Japan. Let's move on to my third topic, train tickets. Here is a picture of the first train ticket. The first train ticket was imported from England with train. So we can see English on the first train ticket. Also, we can at the bottom of the ticket, we can see torn section. This is because tickets were punched by train staff before people got on the train for 100 years. However, in 1960, the number of train users rapidly increased and the station was overcrowded. So, in 1967, the first automatic gate was constructed at Kitasenbi Station in Osaka. Also, surprisingly, this is the first automatic gate in the world. The automatic gate can make sure the tickets are available or not and collect them automatically. So it can help to relieve the congestion. Because of the automatic gate appearance, the tickets were also changed. In 2003, the ticket of prepaid system began, and it's especially called Ikoka in Kansai area. This is because Ikoka stands for IC operating card, but it is also play on a phrase. Ikoka sounds like Ikoka, which means let's go in Kansai dialect. Also, Ikoka has two functions. If you touch Ikoka on the automatic gate, you can use Ikoka as a commuter pass. Also, you can use Ikoka like a credit card to buy something in the station. In my conclusion, Japanese train has a short history but connects all of Japan. Japanese people's life become better and more convenient because of Japanese trains. Japanese train is necessary transportation in Japan. Thank you for listening. Next, Matthew will tell you about train commuters' life.
Thank you, Saki. My name is Maki Furukawa. Now, I will talk about the Japanese train commuter's life. I have three topics, Japanese commuting, Japanese behavior, and punctuality of Japanese trains. Let's begin Japanese commuting. First, I will describe the necessity of Japanese train for commuting. The population of Tokyo is about 30 million people. Tokyo is a capital in Japan. However, when they include commuters from neighboring prefectures, there are over 30 million people in the Tokyo area. This is a ratio of people using their own cars or trains for commuting. Look at the green area. In Tokyo metropolitan area, only 9.8% use their own cars. In contrast, the purple area shows about 71.8% use the train system every day. Even national average, the purple area shows about quarter of people use the train system for their commuting. By the way, it is usual to take 1 hour or more for commuting with trains for commuting in Japan. In my case, it totaled 2 hours from my house to university, and I spent over 1 hour on the train, including transferring trains 3 times. This is about 51.3 miles. Next, this is a picture of Shinjuku Station in Tokyo. During rush hour, trains are very frequent, although they are terribly crowded. Many people have to stand for a long time. Moreover, in Tokyo or some places, they have pusher, packing passengers into train during rush hour. They wear white gloves and push gently. Let's move on to my second topic, Japanese behavior. Now, I will tell you what happens on Japanese trains. First, Japanese people are not demonstrative on the train. People keep themselves quiet and try to keep good atmosphere. Next, what do people usually do on Japanese trains? They find a way to protect their privacy, and they usually read books or focus on using their cell phones. Besides, it is not at all uncommon to see people as if they are the world, like this picture. Did you notice? These girls are me and first presenter, Saki. In fact, this picture was accidentally taken by third presenter, Masai. This is not on purpose for this presentation. This is our natural style. However, there are some reasons. They spend a lot of time on the train because they commute for long distance. And they work late, so often catch up sleep. Also, safe environment allows them to sleep. By the way, bags or wallets are rarely stolen from sleeping passengers. Let's move on to my third topic, the punctuality of Japanese trains. First, I would like to explain how amazing the Japanese punctuality is. For example, Tohoku Shinkansen, as Saki mentioned, which is a bullet train that runs about 120,000 times a year. Yet, an average delay time is only 36 seconds. Also, local trains, which is an electric train that runs every few minutes, yet an average delay time is less than 1 minute. In addition, in Japan, every platform of stations have stop positions. Trains always stop there correctly. Moreover, passengers line up for waiting them. It is very helpful that the train depart on time, because they can get on the train smoothly and fluently. Next, I will explain what happens if the train are late. There are some reasons, such as some accidents, signal problems, or weather. In Japan, even only 1 minute delay, people can know about it on the electric board. Moreover, words of apology, including reasons and place, are announced for passengers. Finally, I will introduce an interesting paper called 遅延token. In Japan, if the train are late more than 5 or 10 minutes, the train company issues this paper. This is a delay certification on which is written how long the train was delayed, when, and where it happened. This paper is for passengers, especially businessmen or students. The purpose of this paper is to prove to their office or teachers of classes the reason for being tardy was unavoidable because of the delay of the train. In my conclusion, in Japan, majority people depend on trains, especially for their commuting. And hundreds of people move together. Also, you can see some Japanese values, such as they are reserved and keep themselves quiet. And they expect it being punctual in their daily life. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, Maki. My name is Masae. From now, I will talk about the dark side of trains. As Saki and Maki said, Japan is one of the countries where many people use the train. Now, Japanese train is necessary for our daily life. However, there are also problems among the Japanese train network. Of course, it is uncomfortable to talk about it, but I think it is important to know how these accidents made Japanese train develop. These are my three topics: train suicide, train accidents, and human-only train cars. Let's move on to my first topic, train suicides. Train suicides often happen in Japan, and it especially happens at the center of the city. Because of train suicide, 35,300 trains were delayed or cancelled in per year. So it means train suicide happens every day. If one train are delayed or cancelled, about 7,000 people were influenced. Because of train suicide, train company think about idea to prevent train suicide. For example, there are emergency stop button at the platform. If someone falls on the railway, other people push the button, and then alarm sounds at the platform and office. At the same time, the driver receives a warning, and then the driver can stop the train. Other example is platform barriers. When train came to arrive to platform, the barrier opened automatically. Let's move on to my second topic, train accidents. In this topic, I will talk about two accidents. One accident is derailment accident. 8 years ago, April 25th, derailment accident happened at Amagasaki, which is near my university. The driver drove the train too fast, and then train slipped at the sharp curve and crashed into the apartment building. So it happened in the morning, so there are many passengers who went to work or school. Finally, this accident caused 668 casualties. After the accident, the train system was changed. At first, a number of trains was decreased. Before the accident, 8 trains ran every hour. But after the accident, train company decided 4 trains ran every hour. So it means 140 trains were decreased in a day. Also, train line color was changed. It changed blue to orange. Because train company consider people who lost family or friends at accident. So if people watch the blue line, people remind of the accident. That's why train company decided to change train line color. By the way, there are not only sad accidents. From now, I will talk about good story about Japanese train. It was an admirable accident around all over the world. In this summer, when a woman got on the train, she fell down between platform and train, so she couldn't get up by herself. Other people noticed her, and then they called train staff by pushing emergency button. And then train staff came to her. At first, they tried to pull her, but it was not going well. So finally, 44 passengers and 60 staff pushed the train, and then she was rescued. Surprisingly, she was not injured. After only 8 minutes, the train started to drive again. Let's move on my final topic, female-only train cars. There are many kinds of train in Japan. One of them is female-only train cars. It was introduced by many countries, but Japan is first country to introduce this train. In 1912, first female-only train cars was introduced because of woman discrimination. At that time, it was not good for woman to ride the same cars with men. However, it was disappeared soon. And then, now we have female-only train cars. But it was different reason. In 2000, this train was introduced again because of groping. And from this year, children, elderly people, and handicapped people can ride this train even if they are men. As you learned, female-only train cars has long history. It was reliable for women, but there are also problems. After this train was introduced, thousands of Japanese men were arrested because of groping in per year. But some cases were mistakes. So some people suggested men-only train, but it has not appeared now. In conclusion, there are many sad accidents in Japanese train. These accidents connected with Japanese society. And also, Japanese people learn from accidents, and then they try to make an effort to solve these accidents. From these accidents, we can see Japanese wonderful character. Thank you for listening.
Presentation. The train which have developed in the short time the most is indispensable transportation in Japan. Many people depend on train for their daily life, especially their commuting. On the other hand, there are many sad accidents, but they all lead to the development of Japanese train in the future. From our presentation, we can say,
No train, no Japan!
Thank you for listening.